From lowest to highest, I tested all Valorant's graphic settings to reveal the best for FPS and performance. Reduce ping in games with no ping, link in the description below. With multi-threaded rendering, there were no major differences in GPU usage, video memory, or average FPS. However, if you have a processor with multiple cores, it's best to keep it set to 1. With material quality, GPU usage, and video memory both increased on medium and high, with the highest usage at the high preset. Average FPS stayed the same on medium but dropped on high. For GPUs with more than 4 GB of VRAM, I recommend selecting medium, otherwise select low. With texture quality, video memory usage went up on medium and high, especially on high, but GPU usage stayed the same. Average FPS was basically unchanged across all presets. If your GPU has more than 4 GB of VRAM, you can safely select high, otherwise select low. With detail quality, GPU and video memory usage didn't really change, but average FPS dropped noticeably on medium and even more on high. To get higher FPS, it's best to select low. With UI quality, no changes in GPU usage, memory usage, or average FPS between medium and high. Since performance doesn't change, I recommend selecting high for better interface visuals. With vignette, no differences in performance at all. You can leave it on without losing FPS. With VSync, GPU usage dropped, video memory stays the same, and average FPS also dropped. To maximize average FPS and performance, keep it off. With anti-aliasing, GPU usage went up with MSAA2X, MSAA4X, and FXAA, with the heaviest usage on MSAA4X. Video memory usage also increased, highest with FXAA. Average FPS stayed similar overall, but was slightly higher with FXAA. If you have more than 4 GB of VRAM, select FXAA, otherwise select none. With anisotropic filtering, GPU usage went up at 2x and 16x, while 4x and 8x were about the same. Video memory stayed stable and average FPS barely changed, with a small bump at 2x, so select 2x without losing FPS. With improved clarity, GPU usage increased, video memory stayed the same, and average FPS dropped when it was on. For best average FPS and performance, keep it off. With experimental sharpening, GPU usage went up, video memory stayed the same, and average FPS dropped, so best to keep it off. With Bloom, no changes to performance at all, you can leave it on for better visuals without losing FPS. With Distortion, no impact on performance, so you can keep it on. With Cast Shadows, GPU and video memory stayed the same, but average FPS dropped with on. To get the most FPS, it's better to keep it off. And that was the video. Let me know in the comment section below if this video was helpful to you. If you want to boost and optimize performance in other games, you can subscribe to this channel and then always learn new methods when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.